Hello students, today let us learn about living world. So the word living world is nothing but our surrounding. So the things around us is environment. So we see many things in our environment like hills, forest, river, insects and birds and so many other things around us which make us wonder. In our living world, we come across living and non-living things. So what are living things? Living things are the one where life exists in them and there is a movement. Whereas non-living things, life doesn't exist. They are stationary. So let us see the examples of living things. So the examples of living things are humans, trees, animals. The examples of non-living things are stone, paper, book. All that are examples of non-living things. Now let us learn about environmental components and let us classify them into living and non-living things. So birds. Birds are living things. Balloon. Balloon is a non-living thing. Water. Water is a non-living thing. Mango tree. So trees are living things because life exists in them. Vehicle. Vehicle is a non-living thing. Pen is also a non-living thing. Now let us learn the characteristics of living things. So there are 9 characteristics of living things. Now let us see one by one. The very first characteristics of living beings are, living beings are made up of cells. So you must have observed how a house is being constructed. When several things such as bricks, cement, water, all these are arranged, the house gets ready. So similarly, the body of living beings is made up of cells. So in the picture, you observe the animal and plant cell. So the body of living beings is made up of many cells. The second characteristic is living beings respire. So living beings take in air. So we breathe in oxygen in order to survive. So living beings take in air, use the oxygen and give out carbon dioxide during respiration. So similarly, plants also depend on oxygen for their respiration. So usually plants respire through stomata. That is nothing but a small openings which are present on the lower surface of leaves. Now let us learn the third characteristic, that is living beings eat food. So every day in our day-to-day life we have food. So why is food necessary? So living beings need to take food to get energy and perform life processes. The intake food helps to perform all the activities. So the food is a basic ingredient which plays a superior role in maintaining function and development of organisms. So the food we eat consists of many nutrients. So in order to do our day-to-day life like cutting, carrying, load, all these activities, we need food. Now let us see what kind of a food the plants make. That is the food of plants. So green plants produce their own food. That is why green plants are called autotrophs. Let us see how plants prepare food. So we know that from the sun we get the solar energy. So plants use solar energy, carbon dioxide in air. They absorb the water, minerals and salts from the roots and prepare food with the help of chlorophyll that is present in the leaf of a plant. So this process of preparing of food is called as photosynthesis. There are few plants which depend on insects for nitrogen. Plants like Drosera, Nepenthes and Utricularia depend on insects, so they are known as insectivorous plants. Now let us see food of animals. Animals do not prepare their own food like plants. They depend on plants and other animals. Therefore, animals are called heterotrophs. So, based on the food animals eat, they are classified into three types: herbivore, carnivore, and omnivore. So, what are herbivore? Animals that eat only plants and plant products are called herbivore animals. And carnivore, animals that eat other animals are called carnivore. Let us learn about omnivore. Animals that eat both plants as well as animals flesh are known as omnivore animals. So the examples for herbivore is cow, that is only plant product, and for carnivore, tiger. So tiger eats other animals. The example for omnivore is bear. So it eats both plants and animals. Now the fourth characteristic is living beings grow. So all living things grow during their lifetime. So even we grow. Similarly, whether it is an increase in size or change in shape, all living things grow. So most living things need oxygen, water, and food to grow. So they are the basic ingredients need for the living beings to grow. So students, today we have learned four characteristics. Go through it. Watch the video 2 to 3 times and be clear with all the concepts and try to solve the worksheet. Thank you.